Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Lightning Slim here with the incomparable Dill Hero. You're watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs live from Cleveland, Ohio. Brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Burning River Roller Derby.
Right, let me talk about the two teams we're about to see go out on the track today. Oklahoma Victory Dolls from Oklahoma City, the Oklahoma All-Stars, are going up against Brandywine Belligerents from Downingtown, Pennsylvania. Now, Oklahoma is seed 9 in this tournament, ranked 58 WFTDA, and Brandywine is seed 10 WFTDA, ranked 62.
Let's take a quick look at the rosters for the Oklahoma Victory Dolls, the All-Star squad. They will be wearing black in this contest, starting with 00, Mount Crushmore, 11, Genetees, number 12, Check 1-2, number 14, T-Pain, number 21, Ace of Spades, 28, Lethal Lamb, 42, Scarbomb, 46, Fatal Inferno, number 6, Rachel Coffey, 8, Whoopsie Daisy, 82, Menace, number 85, E-Bomb, 928, Dita Von Casualties, and KO, Polly Punching Pocket. They will be coached by Shooter Strychnine.
And for the Brandywine Belligerents, 101, Rapid Arrhythmia, 121, Crash, Banchicoot, number 138, Buenos Dias, number 1979, Lurs Lemon, number 23, Thresher, number 2320, Velociraptor, number 24-7, Anya All Night, number 273, Not Naughty, number 67, Slam Shine Alley, number 728, Ballerinka, number 757, Cutthroat KC, 789, Decorator, number 79, Raggedy Aneurysm, number 9, Skinny Guinea, and their coach, Hot Wheels, Brandywine Belligerents.
Skating officials for the game, head referee, Tootie Tin Whistle, inside pack, Penny Whistler, jam referee Just Mo, jam referee Jean-Philippe Amin, outside pack Izzy Demented, outside pack Trial and Terror, outside pack Ogre, and our referee alternate Helen Bayonne.
Well, both of these teams are coming into this bout bettering their seed coming out of this bout. The lowest they can go after this, if you look at the playout, is seed 8. But right now, they're battling for a position to try to get to the game that'll give them either 5th or 6th place coming out of this bout, out of this whole tournament.
And you can guarantee both of them want that, to go as high as they can coming out of Division 2 here in Cleveland.
Yeah, great games by both of these teams coming up to this point where they are definitely getting ready to face off.
A little dancing on the line. Some smiles all around. Everybody's loose before it turns into all business right about now.
Loose and fancy free. All right. Fresh off of the skater line, we have Fatal Inferno for Oklahoma and Buenos Dias for Brandywine.
Fatal Inferno is in the center of the pack. She finds the inside line, scoots out a lead jammer. Fatal Inferno for Oklahoma. Meanwhile, inside the pack, Buenos Dias is pushed out in turn number 2 and recycled. Fatal Inferno on the scoring pass. Three wall facing Fatal Inferno. She forces them to pack closer together, gets a multiplayer blocking penalty out of the deal and comes out of the pack with 5 points.
Right, DerbySupply.net penalty box claiming one in the first jam.
Buenos Dias trying to make her way through the pack. A braced wall of three awaiting her. She pushes away into the center of it, but is pushed out in turn number 4. Meanwhile, Fatal Inferno facing similar problems. G's bumped outside also. Both of these jammers taking some physical punishment.
A lot of hangups right there inside of turn 4.
Buenos Dias now skating in the free and open spaces, but it is Fatal Inferno who has the ability to turn off the tap. She does so after taking 5 more for Oklahoma.
Well, there we go. 10-0, first jam. Very productive for Oklahoma. 28 and change. We're just getting started. 10 points for Oklahoma. Brandywine, 0.
In the red for Brandywine, Lurtz Lemon. And she will face Check 1-2. Lurtz Lemon makes a play to the outside, takes a hit, but maintained wheel side down, comes out of the pack. She has lead. Meanwhile, check 1-2. Still stranded at the outside of turn number one as Lurse Lemon jumps the apex and cruises on through. That is the full five.
What you're seeing, the belligerents in red right now, lead jammer 5 points, putting their first scores on the board. Oklahoma in black sitting at 10.
Lurse Lemon now cuts the track, receives a penalty, skates straight over to the derbysupply.net penalty area.
She's trying to call it off, but that penalty came right in prior to her ability to do so.
Check 1-2. Trying to reestablish dominance for Oklahoma. They lead by 5. She's looking for more. Turn number 2, she's pushed to the outside, quickly re-enters. Getting a bit of jammer support from her pivot, passes the helmet cover. Star pass for Oklahoma.
Not yet successfully engaged as the jammer. Menace.
Menace, yeah, but she's now on the receiving end of the attentions of Brandywine's blockers. She's wearing the star, but can't get much going. Now she escapes the pack.
Yeah, she just escaped the pack, having a little bit of trouble getting that star on her helmet, but once she did, she could concentrate on the pack and busted right through it.
Of course, in the meantime, Lurse Lemon has been scoring, continues to do so. Out with 4, that will bring Brandywine to within a single point of Oklahoma.
And 4 more on the board for Oklahoma.
Both jammers in scoring position, able to trade points. Out of play penalty assessed there to Jenna Tees. Jam is called.
4 more points on the board for Brandywine and 3 more for Oklahoma. It's bringing us to 22-18, 26 minutes and change as we're just getting underway.
And it looks like all the scoring for the belligerents has been concentrated into the personage of Lurse Lemon with all 18 points coming at her skates.
Yeah, we're sitting about an equal amount of penalties on both sides, just 2 penalties each.
Raggedy aneurysm. For Brandywine, she has lead. T-Pain skating for Oklahoma, facing a braced structure in front of her, and is squeezed into the center of the triangle, bursts free. T-Pain now skating free, but it is Raggedy aneurysm moving through the pack to take 4 and call it off.
All right, tie game right now, 22-22. These 2 teams playing back and forth, scoring, and so far a very close game as we're getting started.
You know, a tied score at 22 sounds a bit like a palindrome.
Yeah, it could be. Radar Wheels palindrome break brought to you by Radar Wheels. Wonton? Not now.
Not now, because we got a derby to watch. Action underway. Slam Shine Alley, imported from Philly to Brandywine, now jamming for them. She faces Polly Punching Pocket from Oklahoma. Slam Shine Alley, 1 to beat at the front of the pack. She does so, but is knocked to the infield. She gains lead, but is recycled to the back of the pack. Polly Punching Pocket has moved to the front of the pack, but a push-pull defense employed against her. They're forced to let her go outside that zone of engagement. Slam Shine Alley decides not to let Polly Punching Pocket take another stride, calls it off immediately. And we remain at 22 apiece still here.
22 stands. All right, on the fast girl skate line, we have number 138 in red for Brandywine, Buenos Dias. And Fatal Inferno for Oklahoma.
Fatal Inferno barging her way to the front, but a pair of blockers impeding her progress. Buenos Dias trying to keep up with the defenders. Fatal Inferno has escaped the bonds of the pack, and she is flying free. She has lead.
We'll see if we can break this tie game as we go. Still sitting at 22-22, but here we go into the pack.
The pack had a bit of a runaway, although Fatal Inferno was able to negotiate it once for a score of 4. Buenos Dias looking for a little jammer support. Her blocker's opening up some space for her as she makes her way to the front, but Fatal Inferno coming in for more. No pack declared. Buenos Dias exits. She has 4 points. That'll bring them back to an even score.
And Jenna Tees from Oklahoma sent to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Oklahoma grabs 4 more before the shouting is done. Now at a score of 30, Brandywine at 26, and 22 minutes remaining in the first period of play.
Lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. You can check that out at bont.com.
Raggedy Aneurysm, check 1-2, your jammers of the year right now. Check 1-2, goes from outside to inside, spins around the defenders. Check 1-2 of Oklahoma, lead jammer. Meanwhile, Raggedy Aneurysm basically stepping over the apex.
Yeah, she wasn't even high in the air. Stepped right over the apex out of that pack. And Lily check 1-2 to come through on her scoring pass. Calling it off quickly, but not soon enough. 2 points for Brandywine.
Yeah, check 1-2. It looked like she knew she was engaged, and she snapped a quick look over to her bench where she got immediate instructions to call it off.
So 4 points on that last pass for Oklahoma and 2 for Brandywine. And on the Fast Girls start line right now, we have for the belligerents, Slam Shine Alley. And for Oklahoma, T-Pain.
T-Pain with a quick lead. Slam Shine Alley also skating free. Reinforcements arriving from the DerbySupply.net penalty box for Brandywine. A much bigger pack anticipating T-Pain when she arrives. She's able to grab 3 of those points, bringing Oklahoma to 37.
Yeah, 37-28 right now. Oklahoma in the lead. 20 minutes and change left in this first half.
What do you reckon is happening here, Dill? The two teams seem to be mirroring each other's play styles. Is this a sizing up process that's occurring?
Well, you know, there is always a sizing up process. These two teams have never actually played each other ever. So they've watched each other this weekend, I guarantee you. It's hard to tell. Maybe they're going to be evenly matched all the way through this bout. We'll find out, you know, here in a few minutes when things start to settle down. Right now we're seeing Buenos Dias going to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Polly punching pocket, therefore, on a power jam, she pushes until she gets outside the zone and escapes. She has lead.
And Buenos Dias had to leave the penalty box. She didn't enter it in the correct way and had to go all the way around. She had a back block originally, so that's going to cost her time on her penalty.
A little extra time for Polly punching pocket to score, and score she has. She has 5, looking for more, re-entering the pack. They're in turn number 4. Oh, and she gets really low, coming around the outside and scoots through for another 5.
Well, we've seen Polly punching pocket in previous bouts this weekend, a strong jammer for Oklahoma.
Taking a penalty there, however, we will have a reversal of the power jam. Polly punching pocket taking a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty area. Buenos Dias now inside the pack, squeezing through. Oh, and the defenders of Oklahoma rushing all 4 of them to the very front to reabsorb her, and now bridging to stretch this out as long as they possibly can.
Well, they stretched it out as long as they could. They had to let her go, suffering a penalty for it. She is out of that pack, not eligible for lead jammer, but in a scoring pass.
Buenos Dias has scored 5. 18:30 remaining in the first period. Buenos Dias approaching the pack once more. A braided wall of both colors there. She's able to slip around that. 1 more to beat. It's Menace. She spins around Menace with 4 more points as the jam is called.
Well, here we go with a timeout being called by Oklahoma.
Yeah, they're using an official review. We'll get to the bottom of what that's about in just a moment.
Sin City Skates. We don't sell it if we wouldn't play in it. SinCityskates.com. Go check that out. Proud sponsors of the WFTDA.
Shot here of Tootie Tinwhistle, head referee, now listening to grievances.
Grievances while they work that out. We're talking about jammer score right now for Oklahoma. Fatal Inferno has already put 18 points on the board. Menace, 12, and Polly Punching Pocket, 14. Meanwhile, we're looking over at the belligerents right now. Lurs Lemon with 18 points for the jam, and Buenos Dias, 13. Raggedy Aneurysm with 6. Well, this official review, while they discuss it, we'll try to figure out what that's about. We've had lead calls. Oklahoma's had 5 and Brandywine 3 so far in this bout. Still early on.
The head referee giving a very involved description of the question at hand. We'll provide more information as it becomes available.
Be a lifer, get a lifer. S1 Helmets. S1Helmets.com, ladies and gentlemen. So that official review will stand. It was about the jammer being out of bounds.
Oklahoma will not retain that official review. They've used it up. Oklahoma 51, Brandywine, a score of 37, 18 minutes and 12 seconds remaining in the first period of play. Lurs Lemon in the center of a bully circle of 3, although she escapes. I wish I was able to escape from bullies when I was a kid like that. She has lead, Lurs Lemon of Brandywine. Lethal Lamb taking a turn with the star for Oklahoma, but she is firmly ensconced within the pack.
Well, to escape those bullies, you got to be tough, and she is tough right now, taking on the 2-wall in the front, just inside of turn 3. Recycled to the back by Mount Crushmore. Not all the way to the back, though. She found an opportunity to come back in. 5 points right there for the belligerent Brandywine.
Multiple penalties, Mount Crushmore and Ebomb both going to the DerbySupply.net penalty area to be joined by Coffee, and she will find no room at the end and have to rejoin the pack.
She'll just have to serve that later. They'll keep a bed warm for her, so to speak. 5 more points right there for Brandywine.
And that brings Brandywine ahead of Oklahoma, 52-51, and more to come, now 57.
Yep, changing the lead and changing it in a big way, 57-51, like you said, Slim, and back through it again, another 5 points for Brandywine.
That depopulated pack, easy prey for Lurs Lemon. She's taking full advantage.
Oh, we're seeing a forearm block by Not Naughty, sending her over to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Lurs Lemon, number 1979 for Brandywine, on a high-scoring afternoon skate, making her way through the pack. She gets bumped to the interior. I think she decides to quit while she's ahead, calls off the jam.
Way ahead, 51-70 as it comes out right now. 16 minutes and change left in the first half of this exciting bout. We'll call this the battle for fifth place.
Indeed. Fatal Inferno, Raggedy Aneurysm taking to the Fast Girl start line. 1 Brandywine blocker in the penalty area. Advantage Oklahoma in the pack. Fatal Inferno with three, able to get around all three of them with a multiplayer block. Penalty being called against Brandywine. Fatal Inferno now skating in lead for Oklahoma. Fatal Inferno heads to the pack, engages, pushes the outermost blocker, trying to knock her off the track. That does not quite work, and she is recycled.
Well, there goes the jam. Raggedy Aneurysm was making her way around there really quick. She called it off. The jam was called off with 2 points for Oklahoma, zero for Brandywine.
15 minutes remain. If you are just joining us, you are watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs in Cleveland, Ohio. My name is Lightning Slim. His is Dill Hero.
Is mine. All right, and here we go. Off the fast girls start line. Slam Shine Alley for Brandywine and check 1-2 for Oklahoma.
Balarenka taking a seat for Brandywine. But we have lead by check 1-2. Check 1-2 lead jammer for Oklahoma. Slam Shine Alley also skating in the free spaces. On 1 foot, check 1-2 finds some room inside, scoots through four and the door. She is done with that, Dan.
Yeah, they are picking the difference apart right now, 57 to 70. You know, it's still way early. We still got another half to go, so why not just hit your scores and call it off? That seems what she was doing right there. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, these quick jams and call-offs, Dill, you can build a pretty tall tower out of bricks made of 4 points.
Right, and you can mount a serious comeback, as we've seen many times before. Right now, Buenos Dias, jammer for Brandywine, and T-Pain for Oklahoma. T-Pain quick out of that pack. She is the lead jammer.
And she will have further opportunities as Buenos Dias taking a back blocking penalty. Power jam Oklahoma.
Wow, what a battle right there in turn one as Oklahoma is trying to make her way through. Does so, and 5 points right there for T-Pain.
T-Pain with five, looking for more. In a blink, she is around the track, inside the pack again. She faces a braced triangle structure. She is able to break it apart, move through the center, and call off the jam.
No easy task, breaking apart the braced triangle. That is 4 points right there for Oklahoma, 66 to 70. As we sit, 12 minutes and change left in the first half of this Division II playoffs bout.
So tricky to do something like that on the fly. You have to carefully and legally challenge the links in that triangular block and dare them to take the penalty for you before you can get through.
Right now we're seeing lead calls for Oklahoma 8 and for Brandywine 4.
And here is a lead for Brandywine. Buenos Dias has it. Polly punching pocket, knocked to her knees inside the pack, reabsorbed, and score on the board. 5 for Buenos Dias of Brandywine. Trying to reestablish the lead as Oklahoma was creeping up on them. Buenos Dias all getting excellent jammer support from her blockers. They swept and created great room for her on the inside. 5 more for Brandywine.
Right, quite a strong response from Brandywine from the previous Oklahoma damage that they had caused.
They attempt the same thing in turn number 4 on the outside, but Oklahoma, having none of that, as menace was waiting for her and forces her to reset.
Reset, and quickly she does, right outside of turn 1, the last line of defense. Another reset, sending her back to the back of the pack. Finding a little bit of an opening, and out she goes. 5 points for Brandywine.
Brandywine penalty. It is to the pivot. It's not Naughty who will take a seat, but Buenos Dias undeterred by that.
E-bomb taking the jammer responsibilities on Oklahoma, but not in time. The jam is done. 2 more points for Brandywine. And a timeout.
Timeout. Oklahoma.
Timeout for Oklahoma. Adam Skates, train hard, play smart. Skate Adam, adamskates.com.
what is happening in the penalty situation?
Well, as far as penalties go, let's see. We have nobody's really in danger, but we're looking at Mount Crushmore on Oklahoma with four penalty trips. And then on the opposite side, not Naughty with four. That's really the big penalties. There's a couple others here and there, but those are the ones to kind of keep an eye on as we're still, 11 minutes left in this first half.
A little shot of the penalty board there. You can see for yourselves if you're watching us here on WFTDA.tv.
And Oklahoma somewhat doubling lead jammer calls over Brandywine during this first half.
Clock frozen at 10:56. Brandywine, a score of 87. Oklahoma, 66. Timeout is over. We are resetting for more action to come. It will be Fatal Inferno for Oklahoma. She faces Lurs Lemon in the red for Brandywine.
All right. Like I said, 66 to 87. We're getting it underway. Wow, what a strong pass. Not eligible for Lee Jammer. No pass, no foul, but we're seeing cutting the track right now. That's going to send Fatal Inferno to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Lurs Lemon not lead, but eligible to score. She has five.
Yeah, being the only jammer right now on the track, scoring those points. Oklahoma setting up a solid defense just outside of turn two.
And Lurs Lemon just powering through that defense. She was able to barge through, although she was recycled, reapplying herself to the pack now. Taking a hit there from Jenna Tees, and she was forced to put a foot down in the infield. Track cutting penalty and a reversal of the power jam, Dill.
Right, and what we're seeing, Oklahoma jammer Fatal Inferno was released from the penalty box prior to that penalty being called on Brandywine, so there was no swap out. It'll be a full 30 seconds in that penalty box.
Fatal Inferno completes an initial pass, now eligible to score. Menace, a single player goes up to clear some space for Fatal Inferno. Not entirely successful. Fatal Inferno recycled, blows a tire and falls, but quickly back to her skates. Genetees goes to the penalty area. Fatal Inferno now gets a bit of jammer support from Ace. And an illegal procedure will take Lurs Lemon off the track. She had just come back from the penalty area, but she's forced to return from whence she came.
Well, the penalties, just as we started discussing them earlier with just some people with four, are starting to stack up in this jam. 5-4 on that last pass.
We had a star pass to Menace in the late portion of that jam, although it amounted to four more points for Oklahoma. And that will take us to a score of 70 for Oklahoma. Brandywine at 97, flirting with the century mark. 8 minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the first period.
Well, we've seen so much action on that DerbySupply.net penalty box. All your derby needs, DerbySupply.net. Just hit it.
Check 1-2 with a power start. Trying to make the most of it, although Brandywine making life difficult for check 1-2. She does find her way out of the pack and into lead position. Check 1-2 glancing at her bench, gets some instructions, carefully eyeing the pack as she enters, finds purchase on the outside and a full 5 points.
Anya all night sent over to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Weakening the Brandywine defense, as it were.
Lurs Lemon has returned from the penalty box. She has completed an initial pass, and she's getting into the pack once more. But check 1-2, able to close the door before she arrives. 3 more points for Oklahoma.
Well, Oklahoma and Brandywine, like we said, we saw this kind of earlier in the Jet City game where they just couldn't get rid of them. So they couldn't run away from it. 78 to 97. Right now, still in favor of Brandywine.
Yeah, Brandywine has shown an ability to generate leads, but then maybe not keep them for as long as they'd like. T-Pain thought she had the outside of the pack, but instead Raggedy Aneurysm jumps into lead jam position, and T-Pain heads to the penalty area.
Well, what we're seeing right now, Ogre seems to have lost his entire front set of wheels on his skates. So
we are down a truck by Ogre. He is maintaining position at the outside of the track as the alternate referee suits up. Meanwhile, Raggedy Aneurysm in a scoring position inside the pack. T-Pain exiting the DerbySupply.net penalty area. T-Pain, I should say, now hitting the rear wall of Brandywine.
Wow, Brandywine is seriously setting up a solid, always moving defense. Wow, what a hit right there from Velociraptor.
Skinny Guinea taking a penalty for Brandywine. And at the behest of her bench, Raggedy Aneurysm, looking fierce and pleased with herself, calling off that jam.
Right, and keeping up with referee drama today, Ogre skating out to show the head ref that his skate has exploded on him, and off he goes. Alternate ref suiting up right now.
Brandywine, 107, Oklahoma, 78. Helen Bayon suited up and jumping right into the action as an outside pack referee.
Well, here we go. Number 67, Slam Shine Alley, is the lead jammer right now for Brandywine.
Brandywine penalty. Valerenka will take a seat. That was a quick finish to that jam with nothing neither way.
Nothing to show for it. She dove in, called it off immediately as Oklahoma jammer was right on her heels. 78-107, 4 minutes and change left in this first half.
Fatal Inferno taking to the fast girl start line for Oklahoma. She faces Buenos Diaz.
Hey, yeah, don't forget you can talk to us directly on Twitter with the hashtag Talk2WFTDA. It's talking the number 2, WFTDA. We like hearing from you.
Fatal Inferno and Buenos Diaz went hip to hip with each other as the pack stood still in front of them. Buenos Diaz got the better of it as she saw an opening, darted through it. She is now lead inside the pack on a scoring pass. Buenos Diaz looking for room on the outside, a braced wall in front of her. Now both jammers inside the pack. We'll see if Oklahoma was able to achieve anything on a steal. No, nothing for Oklahoma, and a single point for Brandywine. Under 4 minutes remaining in the first period.
And just in on Twitter, Shred Flanders, Raggedy Aneurysm is my new favorite derby name. That's from the Talk 2 WFTDA Twitter feed.
I am fond of that name also, I have to agree.
You did say that earlier. We're not just trying to agree with you here, it's the truth. All right, Lurs Lemon off the line right now, and check 1-2.
Lurs Lemon turning backwards just to make sure that she's gotten out of the pack fairly. She has lead jammer, Lurs Lemon of Brandywine. Check 1-2, also skating free. Lurs Lemon on a scoring pass. Outside to inside. A little S-curve through the pack. Puts up 4 and calls it off immediately.
Yeah, there it is. We're still looking at nobody over 4 penalties in this whole first half. Jenna T's getting up to the 4 penalty mark, but even though we had that heavy penalty jam earlier, still not much to talk about as far as that goes.
Lethal Inferno jamming again. They've been using. Sorry, it's Lethal Lamb for Oklahoma, but Slam Shine Alley for Brandywine has grabbed lead.
Yeah, Lethal Lamb. Somewhat of an alternate jammer this whole weekend, and I think in her previous season at home, and somewhat effective in the Oklahoma gameplay throughout this tournament. But not this time, sitting at 0 and 4 points right there for Brandywine.
Yeah, we were looking at season stats, and Lethal Lamb was used as a relief jammer in the regular season, although she's stepped up her game considerably in this tournament.
That's right. And this just in from Joan Dark. The games have been amazing. That's from the WFTDA. Talk to WFTDA on Twitter.
Buenos Dias, who's done some great work for Brandywine in this first half. She faces Polly Punching Pocket. No lead jammer yet declared. Both of the jammers getting stuck within the pack, but Polly Punching Pocket finds her way out first. Lead jammer for Oklahoma.
Oklahoma now controlling this jam. Buenos Dias quick on her tail.
Polly Punching Pocket spun to the outside by a defensive maneuver of Brandywine, calls off the jam, but able to get two of the points of the triangle that was blocking her.
Right. Joan Dark's right on the Twitter. These games are amazing, and if you're just listening, you need to see this action. It's only $12 for a weekend pass. Next weekend is Detroit. That's going to be a $12 easy $12, and you can watch this action live. We have seen some amazing stuff this weekend. Some upsets already.
In the final minute of play, Brandywine 116, Oklahoma 81. Fatal Inferno, Raggedy Aneurysm, jammers of the right now. And right now, Raggedy Aneurysm has lead.
Raggedy Aneurysm with a nice leap over the corner of the apex. She probably was about 5 feet above the rest of the pack as she landed safely and did it. A little bit of a skip right there, 5 points for Brandywine.
No fear of aerial maneuvers on Raggedy Aneurysm now inside the pack. Using toe stops to move laterally in turn number three. Four blockers attempt to surround her.
Well, right now we're running off of the jammer clock as game clock has hit zero.
Raggedy Aneurysm comes out with 5 points. Multiplayer collision results in a penalty to Fatal Inferno. And Brandywine will end this, perhaps, on a power jam. And so they do.
All right, here we are sitting at the halftime. We're going to go into the halftime. We're going to look at some of the stats and penalties and jammers and scores. And we will be right back with you live here on WFTDA.TV.
That is absolutely right, Dill Hero.
Well, here we go. We were talking about percentage of lead jams here. For Brandywine, Raggedy Aneurysm has a 60% percentage of lead. And also, who are we talking about? Slam Shine Alley has 60% on that lead jam percentage. And on for Oklahoma, Check 1-2 with 60%. So, but we're seeing Brandywine with a stronger percentage of jams, percentage of lead jams.
Right, and on the belligerents, Lurs Lemon, the big score, the score of 65.
Yep, 65. She had 33 in one jam. So we're talking about these two teams pretty fairly equal as far as penalties go. We've got Mount Crushmore at 4, Genetese at 4, and on the Brandywine side, Decker, Hate Her at 4, Skinny Guinea at 4. Also Not Naughty sitting at 4, but nobody really skirting the edge of fouling out right now at this point as we're getting ready to get started. 81 to 126.
And so with penalties even in lead percentages fairly even, what do you think accounts for the difference we see on the scoreboard there, Dill?
Well, it's the difference on the scoreboard is we've had these power jams on the Brandywine side that has really stacked it up. It's just they're having stronger jams. Brandywine's just holding it out. 81 to 126 isn't that far of a difference.
Well, yeah, 50 of those points came from those unanswered points on the power jam. So I guess that's basically all the difference right there.
Yep, and we were talking about the fact that these two teams are already going to end this tournament at a higher seed than when they came in. Oklahoma coming in at 9, Brandywine at 10, and the lowest they could leave as this pans out is 8th seed.
But winning this bout will give them the opportunity to go out as high as 5th.
Yeah, they could come out as high as 5th. So good play from both of these teams upping their seeding throughout this tournament. And here we are, you know, the middle of the day on Saturday, still a whole other day tomorrow to go of wonderful, wonderful roller derby. And you can watch it on WFTDA.tv, $12 pass. It's no thing. You can watch this thing live and see all the fun and action.
It's certainly worth it. Of course, there is also a package for all of the weekends, including championship weekend in St. Paul, Minnesota, where everything is leading up to championships for all the marbles and a chance to win the Hydra.
All right, we're getting ready to get underway. The halftime clock is done.
Yeah, Buenos Dias set up to jam for Brandywine.
And we've got Fatal Inferno watching on in the penalty box as we start this first jam of the second half.
Buenos Dias pushing her way into the center of the pack. Buenos Dias now declared lead as she gets outside the zone of engagement. Eligible to score. Fatal Inferno back from the DerbySupply.net penalty area, but it is Buenos Dias on a scoring run, but recycled.
Well, here we go right now. Oklahoma making the best of it. Oh! Knocked right. Fatal Inferno knocked out of bounds, but didn't have to recycle as a penalty was on Brandywine coming back in. But that's going to leave it. Brandywine scoring 3 points on that first jam and holding Oklahoma to 0.
And that will help Brandywine extend their lead to 129-81. 29 minutes remaining in the contest. Lures Lemon, high scorer for Brandywine, takes to the fast girl start line. She faces check 1-2 for Oklahoma.
And here we go. Lures Lemon stuck in the back of that pack. Check 1-2, trying to make her way to the side, getting pushed out, but staying right in bounds. She is the lead jammer for Oklahoma.
Check 1-2, skating smoothly now, eyeing up the pack, trying to visualize her way through it. She does so, spins around backwards, sees her opponent coming, calls off the jam. A 4-0 in favor of Oklahoma.
Yeah, she called off the jam very feverishly, as if she wasn't seen. She wanted to make sure she was known to do that. That was very close as Oklahoma's coming up. And on the fast girls start line right now, number 79, Raggedy Aneurysm for Brandywine and T-Pain for Oklahoma.
T-Pain thought she had it, but Raggedy Aneurysm out front for Brandywine. She has lead. T-Pain putting on the jets, giving chase. She's trying to force that call off, but Raggedy Aneurysm is going to hit the pack and do what she has done
wow.
So many times before. Jump that apex, securing 2.
Yeah, she jumped the apex very effectively, calling it off. 2 points, like you said, for Brandywine. We're sitting at 131-85, and we're just getting the second half started. And right now on the line for Brandywine, Slam Shine Alley. And for Oklahoma, Polly Punching Pocket.
Slam Shine Alley at the back. Both jammers trying to push the defensive postures ahead of them. Not working the way it used to when they were straight walls. These braced defenses usually can't be moved much farther ahead. Polly Punching Pocket tries skipping around to the outside but is held in place. Meanwhile, Slam Shine Alley is recycled.
Mount Crushmore recycling her way back, and now they're back to the pack action. Oklahoma setting up the four-wall defense in the back. The star has been passed on the Brandywine side, effectively getting the star out of that pack, number nine.
Yeah, Polly Punching Pocket thought she had room to work with, but then looked behind her and saw Skinny Guinea gaining on her, putting on that helmet cover. Polly Punching Pocket had to get into that pack. She calls it off for two.
And talk to WFTDA on Twitter from Brandy Lyons. She loves roller derby. Hello from Cruella DeVille in Phoenix. Well, hello back to you from right here in Cleveland, Ohio.
25 and a half minutes remaining. Brandywine 131, Oklahoma, a score of 87. Fatal Inferno, Buenos Dias, Jammers of the right now.
Well, Fatal Inferno kicking to the outside and diving right into the middle. Buenos Dias again with this Oklahoma four wall in the back, and what we're seeing is Brandywine is having the problems again just inside of turn one, haven't even made it through turn one yet.
Yeah, those links are being challenged and they're having to let Fatal Inferno go, stretching out the pack as long as they can, but outside the zone of engagement, they're forced to let her go. Fatal Inferno now grabs lead and skates on.
Yeah, both these packs had separated widely, and that was to Fatal Inferno's advantage for Oklahoma. And we're seeing Valassa Raptor for Brandywine escorting Fatal Inferno to the outside, forcing the recycle just inside of turn three.
Buenos Dias, with patience, is able to get out of the pack. Fatal Inferno, however, has five more points for Oklahoma. She decides to call that off. Wow. Bringing Oklahoma to a score of 92, Brandywine 131.
Wow, that was Oklahoma is again picking away at it. Like you said, 92 to 131. Lurs Lemon returning to the Fast Girls start line. And again, check 1-2 for Oklahoma.
Check 1-2, push to the outside by Skinny Guinea. That gives Lurs Lemon the opportunity she needs to scoot out ahead. She picks up lead. Lurs Lemon now in a scoring pass, but the pack attempting to run away from her. She's able to pass at least one skater and outside of turn number one, does so.
Well, 3 points right there for Brandywine, 92 to 134, 23. Minutes of change left in this bout. We're on a timeout, official timeout. Made in the USA, made for Derby, Rydell Skates. Check them out at RydellSkates.com.
And Skinny Guinea assessed a late penalty on that play. That will be her fifth.
Right now we're sitting at a score differential of 42 as that official timeout is done and over with. Let's forget about it as the action is back on the track.
Jammers exiting the pack together. Raggedy Aneurysm is the lead jammer, but not the jammer in the lead, and she decides not to play any games and just calls it right off.
Right, jammers were right on each other. T-Pain right there involved with it, and just a smart move. Brandywine calling off the jam, resetting to the jammer line. Polly Punching Pocket returning to the Fast Girl start line with Slam Shine Alley.
The teams moved all the way to the front near the pivot line for a starting position. Bit of run-up room for Polly Punching Pocket and Slam Shine Alley. Polly Punching Pocket immediately moves to the front but is surrounded. Slam Shine Alley on the inside is now lead.
Yeah, these teams decided to start in an old-school way using that pivot line, which is a rarity nowadays. Right now, Brandywine in control of this jam.
Slam Shine Alley gets stuck into the pack, calls immediately. That will do for two, and she manages to shut out Oklahoma.
The second half lead calls, we're looking at Oklahoma 3 and Brandywine with 5.
Buenos Dias and Fatal Inferno. Jammers the now Vail Inferno has done this a couple of times. She does a little button hook maneuver around the wall in front of her and then tucks back into the center. Now, moving to the outside of turn number one. She keeps her skates in fair territory. Vail Inferno, lead jammer.
Well, it worked out for her.
Buenos Dias trailing behind, but also in free territory. Buenos Dias known to be very patient, though. If she can get inside the pack, she can do some damage also. But Vail Inferno calls it off. Buenos Dias did manage to steal a single point, although Oklahoma got four.
Well, here we go. WFTDA, talk to WFTDA. Hashtag Faster Pussycat says, at WFTDA Live, lots of derby love from a tiny town in England. This is awesome. Well, this is also very international as we're getting tweets from England. Yesterday we had a tweet from Australia. Lots of derby all around the world.
Well, good evening, folks in England. Thanks for joining us.
Right now, Lurs Lemon for Brandywine. In the front of that pack, Oklahoma has decided to take the front part of the pack to put on their last defense. She breaks out of it as the lead jammer, Lurs Lemon for Brandywine. Meanwhile, Vail Inferno coming out of the penalty box.
Lurs Lemon through on a scoring pass. That is five. Vail Inferno trying to apply herself to the back of the pack. Gets there, but takes a hit from Skinny Guinea, sends her into the infield. Lurs Lemon, meanwhile, comes out with another 4 points. Vail Inferno having to reset once again. She's being handled by the defenders of Brandywine. As Lurs Lemon, oh, just a little bit too much momentum. Her feet slide out from under her. Lurs Lemon now forced to reset.
Wow, Lurs Lemon, as I'm looking at it right now as we stand, has had 77 points during this bout.
Lurs Lemon now falls, looks somewhat pained, a little slow to get up there, but get up she does and continues on her way. E-bomb putting the hip to Lurs Lemon. She's through once more. Another multi-point pass for Lurs Lemon of Brandywine. Vail Inferno taking a hit from Skinny Guinea. Skinny Guinea has been patrolling the front of that pack.
Wow, Lurs Lemon with another 4 points. I'm talking about her whole points during the game a lot, but that's because here we are. She scored 86 of these points for Brandywine.
18 minutes remaining in the contest.
Well, now we're sitting at a 60-point difference between Oklahoma and Brandywine. Brandywine in the lead. 18 minutes and change left in this bout.
Raggedy Aneurysm, check 1-2. Jammers of the moment. Play has begun, although they took a moment to size each other up. Check 1-2 immediately jumps out to the front. She takes a hit there from Rapid Arrhythmia, but is able to escape. Check 1-2 of Oklahoma is lead, although Raggedy Aneurysm giving chase with speed.
And diving into the back of the pack, immediately calling it off, holding herself and the other team at 0-0 score on that. Hey, don't forget, if you missed out on the exclusive 2014 playoffs and championship merchandise for the WFTDA, you can complete your collection on the WFTDA online store. It's that easy. WFTDA.com/store. A lot of cool stuff there.
T-Pain, Slamshine Alley. Split defense in front of them, each team taking their own zone before the pivot line. This works out to Oklahoma's benefit as T-Pain makes a quick lead. Scoots through, finds the inside, now battling against a defensive posture. She gets tremendous jammer support as her defenders swarm the opposing team. T-Pain skating on through the pack, calling it off as she charges forward to make sure she gets the fifth point.
Yeah, that'll be five more points for Oklahoma, just breaking the 100 mark, 101 to 156. And it looks to, according to the penalty score, Skinny Guinea is going to foul out of this bout for Brandywine.
Yes, Tootie Tin Whistle skating over to the penalty box and has explained to Skinny Guinea that she must leave the field of play.
Well, Skinny Guinea, 22 jams in this bout.
She has been an absolute hitting machine, but that carries its risks, as we know.
Well, we're sitting 16 minutes left in the bout, and we'll see how this will affect Brandywine. And the lead jammer, Brandywine, not affected right now. Buenos Dias now controlling the jam for Brandywine.
Polly punching pocket, escapes the pack also. Buenos Dias on a scoring pass. A beautiful sweep by Brandywine to the inside just before turn number four allows Buenos Dias to put up four. She decides that's enough, calls off the jam. 15 and a half minutes remaining.
All your Derby needs, derbysupply.net. Just hit it. Sponsors of our penalty box.
If you are just joining us, you are watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II playoffs from Cleveland, Ohio. Oklahoma wearing the black, Brandywine in the red. My name is Lightning Slim. I'm joined by Dill Hero.
And off the fast girl skate line, Raggedy Aneurysm for Brandywine and Fatal Inferno for Oklahoma. The action is underway. Fatal Inferno knocked to the outside. Both jammers knocked to the outside, and everybody's recycling way back. We're just going to do some reverse derby. Is it this way on the other side of the equator? Is this how they would play derby? We don't know, but this is all backwards right now.
Things are flowing.
Things are flowing in a strange direction. These skaters have made a complete lap around the track. The jammers have yet to come in. Now we see Fatal Inferno finally getting a chance to come back in. The jammers are back in play.
Strange times indeed, Dill Hero. After all, that is over and done with. However, Raggedy Aneurysm picking up lead, and not only that, a power jam as Fatal Inferno will head to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Raggedy Aneurysm completes a full five-point pass. Gets a sweep there, although she finds a pivot waiting for her. Menace did not fall for that sweep. And they're able, Oklahoma able to set up defensive positions, holding up Raggedy Aneurysm as long as they can. She gets through. That is another 5 points for Brandywine there, reestablishing a commanding lead over Oklahoma.
Yeah, the loss of Skinny Guinea, they are adapting well. I mean, we've only had a couple jams since then, but it hasn't seemed to affect their gameplay as out of the pack they come. Raggedy Aneurysm with another 5 points.
Raggedy Aneurysm inside the pack once more. Fatal Inferno back from the penalty area. Raggedy Aneurysm having a little more trouble on this pass. Menace holding her up as long as she can at the front of the pack, but unable to knock her off her feet, and therefore Raggedy Aneurysm picking up another final 4 points on that pass. 13 minutes remain. Brandywine 179, Oklahoma 101.
Wow. Hey, Bionic, Pilot, Vertigo, winning combination. Jackson Skate, for the love of it, Jackson Skates.
We have a shout out here for the Boomtown Rollers over in Dublin. They are loving the playoffs.
Oh, cool. We're starting to get a lot of worldwide tweets at Talk2WFTDA on the Twitter.
And now the penalty box is empty. We are 80 wheels strong.
Whoa.
Full strength. However briefly, Dill.
Well, here we go, and that's check 1-2 coming out of the pack as the lead jammer, Oklahoma.
And what have I said? Cutting the track, the penalty to Lurs Lemon, power jam, Oklahoma.
Well, here we go, Oklahoma in a good situation. A lot of real estate to make up, but 12 minutes and change. It could still happen, 101 to 179.
Penalty trouble continuing for Brandywine as number 23 Thresher will go to sit with her jammer. And points on the board, 5 for Oklahoma. Check 1-2, calmly approaches the pack. Goes from inside to outside very quickly with a lunge. 5 more points for Oklahoma.
Out there on the track right now for Brandywine, we're seeing number 23 Thresher. She is celebrating 10 years of being cancer-free.
Oh, well, congratulations
today
to her for that. That is wonderful news. Check 1-2 thinks it's wonderful news that she's received 4 points on that final pass. See how overjoyed she is.
Yeah, we can see it. We can see it live and in person, and you can too on WFTDA.tv. All you got to do is get your tournament pass for 12 easy dollars.
Yes, and the championship bouts of this particular weekend still yet to be played tomorrow. There's a whole other day, folks.
Yeah, a whole other day. And next weekend, a whole other tournament, Detroit. Right now we're seeing Buenos Dias breaking out of that pack as the lead jammer for Brandywine.
T-Pain giving chase from Oklahoma. Buenos Dias looking for support.
As the penalty box empties and everybody's on the track.
This time, Brandywine left Buenos Dias alone, and that seemed to be the right decision as she was able to negotiate around the blockers by herself. Smart track awareness from Brandywine. They seem to be communicating well on the track, and they know when to sweep and when to just let it go.
Well, they definitely played the right play there. 183 to 115, 10 minutes. I wouldn't think that they left her alone because they're relaxing, because that's not how it goes here, especially at tournament level.
No lead has been safe thus far.
Right.
Raggedy aneurysm in red for Brandywine. Polly punching pocket in the black for Oklahoma.
And Raggedy aneurysm having a little bit of a trouble with the four wall in the back from Oklahoma and up for Brandywine.
And Polly punching pocket trying to push her defenders in front of her. She does it so just enough to get herself free. Polly punching pocket of Oklahoma is lead on a scoring pass. Collides with two defenders from Brandywine, but finds open space beyond that. Continues forward with 4 points. She's now chasing Raggedy Aneurysm. Raggedy Aneurysm looks behind her, sees Polly punching pocket. May try to impede her way into the pack, but Polly punching pocket says, you may not get into the pack and gain any more points.
Called it before she could engage. Powerdyne Powerdyne Rydell family. Performance plates for Modern Derby game, Powerdyne.
9 minutes remain. Brandywine, a score of 183. Oklahoma, 119. Check 1-2, jamming for Oklahoma. Lurs Lemon. In the red for Brandywine. Lurs Lemon, lead jammer for Brandywine. Very quickly, the crowd responding to that. Check 1-2, not out of the running. Giving chase, Lurs Lemon. Skates around her own blockers. They let her go so she can spin around the outside in turn number 3. And we'll see how many blockers she was able to capture on that pass.
It looks like
some discussion with the outside pack referees just to find out what they saw.
It looks like she might have got 1 point.
Just the single?
The single. Fast Girl Skates. Our mission is educating skaters, so get schooled. FastGirlSkates.com. Score differential right now is 65.
Buenos Dias and Fatal Inferno, jammers of the moment. Whole pack moving is one, but then it splits apart. Buenos Dias getting thumped there by E-Bomb, but is able to maintain vertical integrity and gains lead.
Buenos Dias, strong jammer for Brandywine. 44 points right now this total game.
Oklahoma penalty to Dita Von Casualties. She will take a seat. Oh, and she will be joined by her jammer, Fatal Inferno. Penalty trouble for Oklahoma. Buenos Dias now in sole possession of the star on the track. Comes out with 5.
Whoopsie Daisy had to let her go at the last moment.
Fatal Inferno sitting on 5 penalties. They've been using her quite heavily in a jamming capacity. Buenos Dias taking more advantage of this power jam. Coming out with another 5. A multi-point jam for Buenos Dias.
Whoopsie Daisy and Rachel Coffey, the only blockers right now representing Oklahoma.
E-Bomb taking a seat. This has been a very penalty-heavy jam for Oklahoma. And Brandywine taking full advantage. Buenos Dias inside the pack once more. Brandywine has captured Fatal Inferno as she returned from the penalty area and are keeping her at the rear of the pack to control speed.
Well, Brandy Wine is racking up the points right now. We're sitting at 202 to 119 as we continue to go. 6 minutes and change left in this bout. Five more points for Brandy Wine.
And we saw two teams that seemed very evenly matched at the beginning of the bout, but Brandywine is starting to work their system. Buenos Dias coming through on the inside for one more pass and a single point.
Hey, the Boomtown Rollers would just like to thank us for the shout-out, and they said that we are so awesome.
Well, thank you very much. We are very happy to hear from you and very happy that you're enjoying this fantastic roller derby.
And this just in from Coach Dad, the head ref Tootie with a question mark has been all over these Brandywine pack destruction calls. Good call. So compliment to the referee crew.
A referee compliment.
On WFTDA, talk to WFTDA. You can say anything you want. We might filter it. We might not. We might change it to our benefit. Who knows? Boomtown could have said we're terrible, but we changed it to good. We did not, though.
I think that's what they meant.
Yeah, yeah.
Whatever words they used.
The words they used, we took them as positive.
Brandywine, 208. Oklahoma, 119. We are in an official timeout.
Official timeout. We've had just one ejection from the game, Skinny Guinea, from Brandywine. We have a few other penalty scares going on Oklahoma. Mount Crushmore with six penalties right now. E-Bomb with six on Oklahoma. And we're looking at Decker Hader with six on Brandywine. Not Naughty with five penalties.
Although we should note that Not Naughty has not made too many appearances in this second half.
Right, right.
Clock frozen at 5:35.
All right, waiting for the official timeout. Come to an end. There it is.
That is that.
That is that. 119-209, 5 minutes, 35 seconds on the official clock.
And Raggedy Aneurysm and T-Pain are the jammers. T-Pain makes an immediate play to the front but stumbles over one of the Brandywine defenders. Raggedy Aneurysm steals the moment, gets in front. She is lead and T-Pain forced to chase.
Raggedy Aneurysm just like that around the track. One blocker to contend with. Dives on the outside, calls it off. 4 points for Brandywine. No resistance in turn three.
Raggedy Aneurysm being used in a relief jam capacity by the belligerents, but she has done extremely well, putting up 51 points over the 11 jams she has skated.
And as we saw on Twitter, quickly becoming a roller derby favorite, if not just for her name, now for her jamming abilities.
Lurse Lemon scoots around the outside. She picks up lead. Check 1-2 still captured within the pack. Check 1-2 now skating in the free and open spaces, but Lurse Lemon on a scoring pass. Two to beat. Buffeted by the hips of the defenders of Oklahoma, she nevertheless perseveres, picks up four, calls that.
Well, in the second half here, league calls, Oklahoma's had seven, and Brandywine 14, so Brandywine with double the amount of lead calls in this second half. The WFTDA would like to thank DerbySupply.net, your local host here, Derby City Skates, Sin City Skates, Next Level Skate Shop, 5-on-5 Magazine, and Something Inc. Thank you guys so much from the WFTDA.
Fine establishments all. That official timeout has turned into a timeout taken by Oklahoma. They're taking the opportunity to have a chat, a bit of a reset, as they have quite a hill to climb with 4 minutes, 19 seconds remaining, Dill.
Yeah, well, like you say, 119 to 217, 4 minutes and change. Brandywine, we're talking about how this is going to pan out. Brandywine, if they end up winning this bout, will go on tomorrow to play at 2 p.m. against the winner of the 6 p.m. game against St. Chuck's and Jet City.
Buenos Dias, Pauly Punching Pocket, jamming for their respective teams. Pauly Punching Pocket decides to play a little defense and puts her posterior into Buenos Dias. She then switches to offense. Pauly Punching Pocket moving to the front, but squeezed inside a triangle of Brandywine defenders. Buenos Dias, with patience, pushing the blockers ahead of her. So good at watching her feet and continuing to skate, even though she's hip to hip with a defender. The patience of Buenos Dias. She is pushed out in turn number three. Pauly Punching Pocket still inside that triangle, although she escapes with patience of her own and his lead.
Yeah, broke up the triangle, made it a twofer, and found that inside track, and now she is the lead jammer. Pauly Punching Pocket for Oklahoma.
We have a star pass by Brandywine. Crash Banshikoot now performing jamming duties, although the jam is whistled down. Four more points on the board for Pauly Punching Pocket. Three minutes remain. Brandywine, 217. Oklahoma creeping up to 123.
Hey, you want to see some behind-the-scenes action to what goes on here? Go to Instagram and do a search for WFTDA. It's on there. You'll see all kinds of crazy stuff on Instagram. And we're sitting at a timeout.
These teams were raring to go, and then there was a momentary bit of bookkeeping that needed to be done. So we are in an official timeout.
Official timeout. All right, we're looking at for Brandywine. Lurs Lemon with 91 points, and Raggedy Aneurysm now with 51 points for Brandywine. And don't forget, this is the 10-year anniversary of WFTDA. WFTDA is celebrating 10 years of leadership in modern roller derby, and that's what we're watching right here.
Mount Crushmore has committed the seventh deadly sin, has been asked to leave the track for Oklahoma. That's what was happening in that official review. Back to the action. Lethal Lamb, lead for Oklahoma. Raggedy Aneurysm giving chase. It appears the Decorator for the Belligerents has also left the game.
As we're counting down the minutes, the last few seconds of this bout, we have a timeout right now by Oklahoma, and we have seen three foul outs, two for Brandywine, as you mentioned earlier, Decker Hater and Skinny Guinea, and one Mount Crushmore for Oklahoma.
Three thick red lines on camera there across the score, the penalty tracking board, I should say.
An E-bomb in danger with six penalties. Penalty heavy weekend.
All you stats heads, take a screen grab right now. As a bonus, you get Penny Whistler in the shot.
Yeah, make it your wallpaper.
When we get back to it, it will be Buenos Dias, who's done tremendous work for Brandywine, and check 1-2. No slouch herself with 34 points across 12 jams for Oklahoma.
All right, like we said earlier, Oklahoma coming in seed 9 and Brandywine coming in seed 10 as we're getting ready to get this underway.
So Brandywine has to feel pretty good about the way they performed, Dill.
Yeah, definitely. Both these teams actually should feel pretty good about their performance this weekend, as no matter what happens, they're going to leave a higher seed than what they came in.
They were both pretty smiley before the contest began, although it's been all business since. But they both teams know they've done well. Check 1-2 doing well at gaining lead. Buenos Dias takes a tumble over a defender, a low blocking penalty being assessed there. That will go to Ace of Spades. Jam is called off.
Well, there it is, 3 points in the air for Oklahoma, 0 for Brandywine, 128 to 217, 133 left on the official clock. As we are counting it down, again, next up, St. Chuck's versus Jet City at 6 p.m.
That will be good, my prediction.
That's a good prediction, solid prediction.
T-Pain, Lurs Lemon, jammers of the moment, and a big domino fall down. It's Skaters having to reset themselves. T-Pain pushing, stretching out the pack as long as they can. Brandywine bridging furiously. If you can you build a bridge furiously? They do so.
Well, they did it. If you were going to build it furiously, it just got done.
T-Pain has lead, but Lewis Lemon goes defensive and knocks her down.
Wow, what a hit right there in turn three. 0-0 on that pass, 128 to 217. This is business right up to the end.
Little pirouette there from Raggedy Aneurysm as she has a little nervous energy, perhaps. Fatal Inferno, her opposite number, and room to skate as there is only one blocker on the track for Oklahoma.
Wow, here we go. Raggedy Aneurysm is the lead jammer. Right now we're looking at an 89-point difference with Brandywine in the lead and now also controlling this jam. Zero on the main official clock. We're going by the jam clock right now. She calls it off.
And that will do it for game time. We await final changes to the score, but definitely a victory for the Brandywine belligerents.
Well, Brandywine running away with it in the second half. Oklahoma's holding on in the first half and giving a good battle. It was a good battle up until the end, but Brandywine just setting the standard, and here we are with nearly a 100-point difference.
And I think what happened here, Dill, Brandywine, I think they were good gamblers. They knew when to hold them and when to fold them. They knew when to sweep away and when to let her run.
Wow, that's I've heard that somewhere before, but we've seen it live here today on WFTDA TV. Oklahoma 128, Brandywine 220. Unofficial still, they're going to work that out, obviously. And like I said earlier, Oklahoma is going to go on to play the winner. It's now the final, so no, Oklahoma is 128, Brandywine 220. Brandywine's going to go on to play the winner of this next bout, St. Chuck's and Jet City. And we're seeing Oklahoma setting up a congratulatory bridge on the track.
And that's a great display of sporting enthusiasm.
Yeah, there it is. If you're watching on the stream, it's just outside a camera shot. You can see him coming out of the tunnel of love. Yeah, let's just call it the tunnel of love.
Sure,
right there.
Sure, certainly.
Yeah, good sportsmanship right there. Oklahoma 128, Brandywine 220. Lurs Lemon with an amazing 91 points during this bout.
The high score for Oklahoma, check 1-2, 37 points across 12 jams in a valiant effort for Oklahoma. But I think the difference was, Dill, that the belligerents were able to, in the first half, the two teams were still feeling each other out, but then Brandywine started to work their system, and there was excellent communication between their jamming core and their blockers. They knew exactly what and when to do to get their jammer through.
Right, you said they were feeling each other out. Again, this is their first time they've ever played each other, so they had to figure it out, and they certainly did. With Brandywine moving on, trying to fight it out, they're trying to work their way to the fifth position, fifth seed out of this. Worst they can do is sixth at this point.
Yeah, like you said before, both teams should feel pretty good about what they've done here today. We'd like to thank all of you for joining us here on WFTDA.TV. My name is Lightning Slim. I've been joined by
Dill Hero.
We'll see you next time.